Hey guys, Dan Duran here, and today we're going to do starting point on the hack the box, learn the basics of penetration testing. We are on tier zero and we are doing Mongo D. So this one is already active for me. So what I'm going to do now is just soft reset the machine so we can get rid of all the flags and let's get going. All right. So how many TCP ports are open on the machine? And for that, we're going to do an nmap, obviously. So nmap, and we're going to do O maybe, and then SV. So fingerprint the operating system as well as the version. I'm also going to do every single port. So minus P minus like that. And then maybe PN just in case the server does not allow to ping back. And then let's do this and wait for a little bit. We're going to do every single port on this IP address. I'm assuming that because it's MongoDB, so, and it uses a high port for the database. All right, so here it is, and let's see what we got. So we got two ports that are open, and absolutely 27017 is the port for MongoDB, and it is two open ports. So let's type down two and then submit the answers, and that's what we got. All right, which service is running on port 27017 on the remote host? And we already saw that, so let's go back in here. And that would be MongoDB 3.6.8 and also OpenSSH. So we might as well try that just in case. All right, so let's copy and paste and let's give it a try. So might as well just try the SSH just in case. Password, no password, maybe root, maybe password. It doesn't work. All right, so it doesn't matter. You should always try everything. As soon as you see something, try to put the full credentials. You might get lucky, right? So, all right, let's go back in here. And what type of database is MongoDB? Choose SQL or no SQL. And that would be no SQL. All right, just because it's not a relational database like MySQL or MSSQL, it has a completely different structure. Right, so let's submit that. Task number four, what is the command name for the Mongo shell that is installed with the MongoDB client package? And that one is very easy, it's just Mongo, right? So I'm gonna show you in a second. If you don't have it installed, you should install it so we can get connected. So that would be Mongo like that, right? So if I do Mongo H, here it is, how to connect to the shell using Mongo. If you are using Kali Linux, they just type in apt install Mongo like that with NS there. Right, already have it. So all good. Let's go into the next one. Task number five. What is the command used for listing all databases present on the MongoDB server? No need to include a trailing semicolon. All right, for that, I really want you to pay attention because there's a whole bunch of commands that you have to do with MongoDB. And for that, I have this here from Hattrix. It's a very good readme on how to use Mongo. So if you go down the page, then you can see how to do the scanning in there and then the manual for Mongo as well as some Mongo commands. And right at the beginning, it is show DBS. So that is your answer. So if we go here, it would be show DBS. What is the command used for listing out the collections in a database? And again, you know, you can do this in here. So you can use a DB and then show the collections. And that it is a correct, that's a correct answer. So let's put show collections in here like that, submit the answer, and that's correct. What is the command used for dumping the contents of all documents within the collection name flag, right? So here is the information that we need to get. And if we go here, you'll see that DB collections count. So this could be it. However, if you go in here, you'll see that there's more information in here. So there's this extra information that we gotta gather in here. So why don't we just connect to the Mongo database? So let's just copy the IP address in here. Perfect. And then let's connect. So Mongo, and we're connected to Mongo. So let me just clear this and then let's do show DBS. And we have a few DBS in here. So use admin. There you go. So now we have switched to admin and then show collections. And there's system version. So system version, if we go back to this DB collection find. So that's what we want to do, right? So DB collection, fine. There is a system version in there. Let's type that in, DB and system version. And then it gives me all the information that I can get, right? Version compact, right? There you go. Drop. And then there is fine, right? So let's quit this. All right, it's just giving me information. So let's use another database. So show, let me just clean this up. Show DBS, and then now let's do config. So use config, right? So show collections, system sessions, right? So if I go back a little bit, I can do system sessions, find, there's nothing. Let's show databases again, show DBS, there's local, and then there is sensitive information. So we are going to, I don't think it's local, but I think it's sensitive information or users, right? So let's do, there you go. Okay, and show DBS, and it's sensitive information, right? So use sensitive information. So let me just copy this. There you go. And now show collections, and there is the flag. And then find, and there is the flag, right? So perfect, awesome. So let's go back and let's resolve this. So this is going to be, oh, and we need one more, right? One more. Okay, so let's go back here and count admin flag in a format that is easy to read. All right, so let's just look for something else in here. Mongo, what would that be? All right, so let's see this. Mongo dump DBS, easy to read. Click on this one, and then if I go down the page, you'll see a command in here. Mongo query document, define method, and then the pretty method. Here it is. Oh my God, pretty. All right, so let's go back here. Woof. Right, so let's do pretty. There it is. There it is, the flag. So let me just copy this in here and let's paste this. Now, this is one of those things that you never find. It is so hard to find, and I don't understand why Hack the Box actually put it in there. It doesn't make any sense to me, but who cares? Okay, so that's what it is, right? So let's just do the flag in here, copy and paste the flag right here, submit, and there you go. I mean, okay, so it took a while to be able to find that command for MongoDB. I don't think it's one of those commands that is used a lot. I don't know if you're a Mongo developer and you know how to work with Mongo. Do you use it? That's the question. My instinct is that that flag is not used very much. If you have any questions, any comments, make sure you post them down below, and I hope to see you in the next video. Cheers.